I'm here checking out the Snelheid Leider electric bike, and this is something that's pretty custom. As you can tell here, we've got a carbon fiber battery box that's mounted directly onto that down tube. It's actually drilled holes straight through the frame there, and you can see these Anderson connectors and everything. This is where you would charge it, and this is the key that allows you to basically activate the bike. Once that's put in, you press the on-off switch right here, and you can see up here we've actually got a voltage meter right there on the right with the blue, and then on the left that's actually like a thermometer. It kind of shows you your temperature, and right now we're at like 0.1, 0.2, and it's a relatively warm day here in downtown LA, and that's it's I guess it's good to go up to around 2.0, so you know, plenty of room to just accelerate with this bike and to do some climbing and to get some excellent speed. This is a top of the line bike from Snelheid, and it's capable of going like 27, 28 miles per hour. It's about $3,200, but coming back to sort of what you might want to do with this, as you can see, we've got these little like foot cages, and we've got a single speed design. Okay, so if you were in a city, this would be an excellent sort of around town kind of bike, but it amplifies what you can do and how fast you can go, because of course it's an electric bike, it's battery operated. The motor on this is a Mack motor, capable of like 1,000 watts, putting out 1,000 watts. It's gear design, 5-to-1 gear ratio, which is pretty impressive. So, you know, we're looking at something that's maybe a step up from a do-it-yourself because of the battery mounting position and all of the electronics and everything have already been figured out, but you're really, you know, you're just kind of taking it to that next level, sort of the almost the modification or the hobbyist state with this. Snelheid does have another bike that's a little bit more traditional. Again, this is the Leader. This is their like higher end one. They have one called the Tyro, and that one's like about $2,600, and it's sort of limited to more like that 20 mile per hour top speed, which is something you'd be, you know, that it's more like that legal limit that you wouldn't be doing as a hobbyist or off-road or whatever. Both of them are throttle only electric bikes, so as you're pedaling along, it's just human power, and then you activate that throttle and the thing takes off, and it really does. It's quite powerful. But when you look at this, again, what really struck me when I first saw it was just the weight distribution. Having that battery up front like that makes a huge difference. And the fact that it is mounted forwards allows you to use that seat tube bottle mounting position right there. So you can still have a water bottle. And you can see the pedals here, the clearance is just so that you can get them by. But you still can see that the box kind of extrudes a little bit to the left and right. So if you're riding this, it's possible to potentially clip your foot or your leg or something like that. And that's one of the challenges when you're working on a DIY bike. You've got kind of a back battery option, but of course that's heavy, and it kind of makes the whole bike heavy because the motor itself already weighs about 9 pounds. The battery is like another 11 pounds with the controller and everything like that. So spreading it out, I think it's an excellent choice. And really these are just coming on, I think late 2014, 2015, and picking up in some different shops. I'm actually here with Tony. Hey Tony, how's it going?
Doing good.
Awesome. So he's the founder of Snelheid Cycles, and he brought this out and was, you know, kind of cruising around with it and giving me a quick demo earlier. Do you want to step over here and just, you know, I'm not sure if it sounded like I missed anything. I was kind of giving a quick overview. Do you want to tell me a little bit about the company and what you're trying to achieve with this bike?
Well, we're trying to appeal to the performance enthusiasts who aren't satisfied with just 20 miles per hour or with slow acceleration and compromised handling. This is designed with no compromise in mind in terms of performance, so it's going to accelerate quickly, get you up to speed, and it's also an efficient design that has the range to take you as far as you need to go.
Excellent. Yeah, what is the range on it? Because I didn't mention the battery voltage. It was like 52 volts or something?
Yeah, the Leader runs on a 52 volt system, which has 414 watt hours battery capacity.
It's like 8 amp hours?
About? 8 amp hours at 52 volts, which is good for roughly 25 miles at 20 miles an hour without pedaling. With pedaling, obviously, it's a lot further.
And it's a relatively lightweight bike. You were in the sort of the mid-40s? Or?
Yeah, the Leader comes in about 46 pounds. And the Tiro, with a smaller capacity battery, is about 45 pounds.
Awesome. Well, it's definitely, it appeals to my sort of like city riding efficiency, it's stiff, you know, all that kind of stuff, right, when you're cruising around.
It was designed for the urban environment, so it's not going to be the greatest, you know, off-road, but
of course,
it's definitely strong enough to handle potholes, manhole covers, anything unexpected with the wider tires. And
awesome. Well, okay. You know, I've got the camera here. Would you like pick up the seat and kind of rev the motor, and I can kind of show the BMC in action here? Nice. Relatively quiet. And so this is sort of a geared design, you were saying, with that 5-to-1 gear ratio?
That's right.
Right, okay. So you get a smaller footprint?
Smaller package, lighter weight, mm-hmm. With equal to more torque than a larger comparable wattage motor.
Yeah, that's awesome. And you said you were kind of a fan of Endless Sphere, and you've read through their forums.
Absolutely. And spent a lot of time researching, learning.
Awesome. So that was kind of like where some of these ideas originated, and then you put it all together, and you've got your own company now.
Right. I took the best ideas I found from other people and incorporated some of my own original ideas, and This is the end result.
Okay, well, you know, we are downtown. It's a little busy. Do you want to like ride by a little bit, and I can film you on the bike?
Absolutely, I'd love to do that.
Yeah, because I've heard the motor now, and maybe you can just you can hop on it. Yeah, you can see it just zips. Wow, and this one's capable of going like 27 miles per hour. So you can see he just flies. It's really quiet. Well, Tony, thank you so much. Awesome to get to see this in person.
Yeah, absolutely.
Appreciate you taking the time to come out. Maybe I'll jump on it real quick, and you know, I don't want to get hung up on the cages and stuff. No, it's okay. Oh boy. You can see the battery box, you know, the clearance is all right. So I just took the test ride, and I noticed there was, you know, good clearance for my feet. I kind of shot the camera down that way, but I wanted to show it a little bit closer up. Tony's on the bike right now. Hey, Tony.
Hi.
So can you just, you know, kind of pedal backwards? You can see that most of the box is actually, you know, further forward than really any of his body, and then of course the foot passes right by, but it doesn't touch. And you know, in order to get that larger battery, get that range and that power, you've got to put the cells somewhere, and you've got this super lightweight box. It's pretty efficient, it keeps the price down. So, you know, very cool. Thanks for doing that little. Do you want to go back one more time? Yeah, very cool. It's excellent. Thanks again.
Yeah, thank you.